some people, first time going to film, all my cars together.
Yeah, they call me Glock and the G stand for greatest. Married to money, tell her that I'm taking. Cutthroat the gang, better yet we the name. And bitch, I'm that nigga, it ain't no debate. Fuck it, I might bulletproof the Mercedes. Yeah, I'm playing with this paper. I'm ballin' like Kobe, these niggas can't hold me. I might put up 81. Everybody know me, it's M.O.B. Until I'm 81. Yeah, bitch, I'm that nigga,
a made one.
Black diamonds, I'm a Jacob.
Acorn.
Bring it to your dog like Avon. High as hell, might hit you with a rave. Where I'm from, you don't got it, then take some. Yo, smoking on Zod, no fake. Runs. Where I'm from, you ain't gotta then take some. I'm smoking on Zod, no dip. I rent that money up, no elevator or no steps. Got a bad bitch to my left. I can do bad by myself. Nine letters, you know what I rep. Cutthroat, frat 10, we stealth. Cutthroat, Golden State, I'm stealth. Nah, better yet, I'm Steve Kerr. Glizzock, that nigga, yes sir. Run up on me, double dirt. Heart cold as a polar bear. And I ain't hotter than a fucking desert. I spent 20,000 on some fur. Then spent 30,000 on some leather. Say that bullshit for the birds. Bitch, I'm on a whole nother level. Say that bullshit for the birds. Bitch, I'm in a whole nother lane. Got rich, shit start to change. Got rich, shit went left. And before you get an M, you know you gotta take a L. These niggas pussy, that's what I smell. These niggas pussy, these niggas hoes. South Memphis nigga ballin', I get every penny. 20 pointers in my mouth, a shout out to my dentist. I just did a meet and greet and signed a couple titties. If a nigga play with Key, yeah, it's gonna be a killing. Hit that little bitch from the back.
What's up, people? First time I'm going to film a video with all my cars together. I'm going to show you all my collection. Show them quickly what we have here, just a quick. That's it. So, guys, let me start with the first one that I got in the collection. BMW M4 GTS, one of 600 in the world. This car is nasty. This car is like fun. And for what you're paying, to be honest, I don't think there's anything better than that. You know, first car I bought in the collection. I've had many other cars that I've been buying and selling. I'm not really attached to anything material. You may see these cars right now. It's like you may not see some of them in the future. As you may see, I add some, as I take away some. Do you know what I mean? I'm in a point right now where like I'm like, why the fuck I have like all these cars? Like there's some cars I haven't used in months. But either way, that's another topic to be talking about. Let me show you all the whips so you can understand my collection right now, understand where I'm coming from. You know, I started as a normal guy working in construction, washing dishes as an immigrant twice in Australia, in LA. And I've seen myself two times in the street. I've lived in the couch of the auntie of a friend for like 3 weeks in LA, you know. Literally, I landed in LA as an immigrant with a backpack living in a hostel. And 2 years after, I bought my first Lamborghini Huracan cash. That didn't happen in 2 years, bro. That man that did that in 2 years was being built since he was 13, and I bought it with 27 years old. So you need to understand that life is pretty simple, and just people try to add complicated stuff, and they want the result faster than it can come. So just never stick to a plan, bro. What if you could receive the blueprint that actually works and just stick to it every day? Simple, right? It's actually that, okay? Second car that I bought, let me show you, it's this one. As I say, I've had like many other cars. This Lamborghini Urus, this is from my wife. White body, 1016 Industries. Custom made for Giotto rims, 24 inches. Lowered, downpipes, stage 2. Charge pipes, I think it's like 850 horsepower, something like that. It's a monster. It's been quite a while in the collection. Like this car, I bought it a year and a half ago. I don't know, 2 years.
Vegas.
Huh? Vegas. Probably like nearly 2 years, bro. So, a year and a half. So I don't remember, bro. Either way, this is my wife's car. You need to treat your woman is an extension of you, bro. You know, if you have a nice whip, you have a nice watch, but your chick doesn't have anything nice, let me tell you something, you're a piece of shit, basically, you know, because your wife, your girlfriend, if it's like a stable one that you've been time with her, is one of the biggest pillars in your life that's gonna give you support, spiritually, emotionally, you know, it's gonna be there when you need it, and she deserves the best, bro. You know, if you don't see that, you're just selfish. You start being more selfless and give more. Next one we have in the collection is this one is the next one, Lamborghini Huracan STO, lowered, slammed to the floor, stage two, downpipes, straight pipe, a titanium. This thing is a beast. Let me. People get confused sometimes. I've said like the Lamborghini Huracan is the broke people Lambo. Look, bro, this is what I think now about a stock Huracan. Okay, look at my car collection. When I first bought Lamborghini Huracan, that was the best feeling ever, dude. You know, I'm never being, how you say in English the word, putting down someone that has a Lambo. Any Lambo is crazy achievement, bro, okay? But this is the level where I am right now. You wanna listen how a guy that owns a Bugatti feels in his mind? Well, that's his feeling, dude. Like, if you're gonna get offended, well, just don't get into that mind. But if you wanna level up, you know, understand that that's how I think, and I'm always gonna be real of how I think. I love this car. This car is amazing, it drives amazing. It's amazing inside, all Alcantara. It's a very, very, very well-made supercar. And it's a very usable daily driver. But to be honest, I barely use most of these cars. I mostly drive like comfortable cars, like a Rolls Royce. You know, I see myself driving a lot, the Rolls Royce, the G-Wagon, the Urus, you know. But yeah, I mean, this is, how many Lambos I bought in total? One, two, three, four, five Lambos I bought in total. But check this, I'm 32 years old, you know. I came 7 years ago to the US and I had a backpack. All this in 7 years. It's crazy. Next one, which is the next one?
Ferrari.
That's the next one I bought, Ferrari 458 Spider. This thing is crazy. I rather bought this one before an F8, SF90, 488, just because the experience, this car is a classic. I'm just like, you know, that poor GT2 RS is turbo, you know, and like, barely driven it, bro. I just feel like driving more this or a Huracan or like an SVJ, you know, it's more fun. But hey, each to its taste, you know. This car is nasty, one of one interior, made by a Ferrari. Lowered Veloz wheels, custom 21, 20, I think it's 22, 21, I forgot, wheels. Lowered downpipes, exhaust, titanium. This thing sounds like a Formula One. It's crazy, you know? But here, nice white, it's a very special white also. SVJ Lamborghini Aventador Roadster SVJ, one of 800 in the world. One of one interior, it's a blue safe view, something like that. Jean Tani. Crazy Veloz wheels, lowered. This thing is like absolutely nuts. It's beautiful. Texas Steel Industries hood. I mean, this has always been my dream. The car where I got more emotional buying in my life was the first nice car I bought to my wife, a Range Rover Evoque. I got more emotional. I actually cried when I bought her that car than any other cars. But after that one, was the Lamborghini Huracan, the first supercar I bought. I got emotional. I just, driving it back home, I had a few tears coming down, but it was not because of the car, bro. It was just remembering everything, dude. Like, remembering all those no's, all that people, like, I'm just getting, like, goosebumps, you know? All the people that were saying, you can't do that, you're not gonna make it, that's not possible, and like, all that just came through me when I was just driving that Lamborghini, you know? And it just felt crazy, bro, you know? And then this one was a very special moment because it was just finally the Aventador that I've always dreamt of. You know, I had the regular Aventador, but let me tell you, it has nothing to do. Yeah, it's great, it's amazing, it's beautiful, but this thing is just another level, bro. It's another thing, you know? Porsche GT2 RS. Yellow Signale. There's only 1,000 GT2Rs in the world, 500 in the US. I think it's only 22 Yellow Signale in the world. Here's one. And this thing is beautiful. To be honest, I haven't even driven it that much. It's the first car. It's scary to drive because you hit it in fourth, fifth gear and just go sideways. It so fast. I did stage two, downpipes, charge pipes. This thing is nearly 1,000 horsepower. I don't know exactly, like, but it's crazy. And what can I say? Like, the story of this car, I was gonna buy a GT3 RS, but a friend told me, hey bro, I'm gonna sell mine, you want it? I just got it from my friend. You know, you always rather buy a car to a friend than any other, you know? So that's it, man. Not much to say. You see, they're all in chargers. They're all with trickle chargers, as you see. Just because, I don't know when is the next time I'm going to use it. Sometimes I don't even know why I have so many cars. But the thing is, like, in life, bro, let me tell you one thing. It's a very, very, very good piece of advice I'm going to give you guys. And it's going to be hard for you guys to understand. And you're probably not going to understand this, but you guys think that I'm happy because I have all these cars. And actually, having all these cars makes you unhappy. That doesn't make sense, right? It's not going to make sense for any of you guys if you don't have all these cars. If you have all these cars, you would understand, because the more material stuff you own, you have, the harder you need to work each day just to feel that you deserve it and just to be grateful. Because I've seen myself that God doesn't like when you have stuff just to have it and you don't use it, you know? So I find a hard time using all the cars, and you always tend to use your favorite ones, like the Rolls Royce. I haven't used it in a long time, the Cullinan, or the GT2 RS, or the BMW. So that's the thing, guys. Don't think that success in life is having a lot of cars or making a lot of money. Success in life is just being in peace with yourself interiorly, being free spiritually, and just working every day in something that you love that really impacts the world, you know. But I just wanted to leave that there to understand, because your goals and your focus in life is gonna change. Obviously, my focus at the start was, like, obviously buying cars and, like, material stuff, and it switches, you know, but it's part of the process. I'm just letting you know, I feel good because of who I am, and that's the process I have every day. Hits reset. When I wake up, I put the work. Yesterday I worked very hard, so today I don't work, doesn't work like that. I bought these three cars together, G-Wagon Brabus 800, McLaren 765 LT, and the Rolls Royce Dom will go now. Brabus kit has the stage one I did, I think. It's this car is so comfortable. You just want to drive it all day everywhere, bro. It's super nice, looks super nice, and it's super comfortable. McLaren, this car is like the hot chick that is so hot. Fake tits, fake ass. It looks physically amazing. This thing looks insane. Custom Velos wheels. I nearly have custom wheels on all my cars, as you see. You know, exhaust, downpipes, stage two. This thing, you rev it and it's crazy. It shoots like gunshots, fire. But bro, like, so many little things break, like the AC, this, that. I bought it 4 or 5 months ago. I've been modifying it. This broke. I barely used it. Literally, they gave it to me 2 days ago, and I've used it 4 times. But it's nasty. You know, but either way, I have to drive it more and let you guys know what I think. Did we do this Rolls Royce? I think we jumped it, right?
Oh, well, either way. Dumb.
We jumped, we'll go now for it. This Rolls Royce, I bought it together with those other cars the same day. It was crazy. I was not even expecting to buy a car. My video guy that's behind, that's also in my phase one coaching, he literally built that man with no fear, you know, and just bought his first supercar. Bam, he did it, bro. That's crazy, you know. Crazy thing to buy a supercar. Either way, when we went to pick it up, I sold those cars and ended up buying three. Long story short, I was not expecting to buy anything that day, and I bought three cars. Kind of crazy, right? But hey, what's life for? You just gotta do crazy shit, right? Rolls Royce, my wife's also, she has two Rolls Royces. My wife has two Rolls Royces, Cullinan and Don. G-Wagon and Urus. This thing is nasty. That color, one of the highest MSRP Dom ever made. Custom Velos wheels, lowered, all custom painted to match the car. It's amazing. This thing, it's this piece. You drive this thing and just say, oh, crazy. I forgot this one. Haven't used it in a while. I was gonna take this car today, bro, but I forgot the keys. I forgot the luggage that has the keys of all the cars, and I'm gonna have to drive again the McLaren that I drove here. What a problem, right? Either way. Wide body 1016 Industries, custom Forgiato 26 inch, we had to cut the chassis of the car. Hey, who the fuck buys a Rolls Royce and cuts it in half? Like me. I do it, you know? Why not? Why are you not going to cut a Rolls Royce to make it wide body, bro? Makes sense, right? Nothing of this makes sense. You know, that's why life is interesting, because you just have to go for it. That's it, and then. Hey, let's not forget, you know, last but not least, Bugatti Chiron. What color is your Bugatti, bro? Mine doesn't have a color. It's blue carbon fiber with black carbon fiber. I don't even like to talk about money anymore, bro. Like, how much money I'm making, how much money is this car, how much money is that? Because it gets you guys to the wrong mindset, okay? But let me finish up with this. I'm only going to tell you, only that car is $3.5 million, which is crazy. I didn't start fitness to buy a Bugatti. I didn't even think of buying a Bugatti a few days before buying. I'm just so focused in the process, so focused in living, so focused in being grateful that everything just flows and comes and you attract everything. But guys, life, you only live once, you're very special. It's a miracle that you're born. Probabilities of you being born was probably zero, and you're here. You have a great purpose. You have some massive skills, gifts that God gave you, and you have to just find them. That's your purpose, building that man, that woman you admire and respect, and just then giving it to the world selflessly, without expecting anything. And that's what's gonna make you really feel good, guys. If you guys wanna connect with me, if you want help with coaching, you know, to get in shape, to drop vices, to build the best habits, to build that person you admire, you know, hit me up a DM on I Am Jaros. I also do business coaching to people that want to build a personal brand like I did. That's how I built all this, with the personal brand and an online business coaching around it that is focused on solving problems that I've already solved. Now you can also do that. Hey, you know how to fix a problem? You can fix that problem for other people. Simple as that. It's been a pleasure, guys. See you in the next video. Let's get it.